about Timmons. Thanks, Riley. As students on both sides of the river walk across the stage, they are stepping into the workforce. And for the medical field, these graduates will help fill out numbers at local hospitals with healthcare shortages, both in the Peach State and across the United States. News 12's Nick Veland went to today's commencement for Augusta University and spoke to students on what this means to them.
Hope and anticipation is in the air for Augusta University's graduation. As 165 nursing students are as excited to enter into the field. These students are graduating at a time where the need for nurses is vital, not just here, but across the nation. From a majority of nurses coming up on their retirement to those just walking away from the career, the drop-off is there. And now coming off of graduation, these students say they have what it takes to step in and attempt to fill the gap. For Jabari Harris, the feeling of walking across the stage will make all the hard work worth it.
I haven't even processed it yet, honestly. It's just like, I won't know how I react until I actually walk across the stage. I feel that I put 16 years in, so this has finally led to that moment.
And coming up on News 12 at 6 o'clock, we'll have more on the nursing shortage. And now six black nurses are going into a field where they're underrepresented. In Augusta, Nick Veland on your side.
Thanks, Nick. A developing story out of Augusta. Two arrests have been made in a deadly shooting on Deansbridge Road. The coroner's office says 23-year-old Michaela Perkins was shot at least one time and was taken to AU, where she died at around 6:30 this morning. Now authorities say 39-year-old Julius Morris III and 29-year-old Raheem Carter have been arrested and are facing charges of murder and gun charges. We are working to get the police report to find out what led up to this shooting. And the Richmond County Sheriff's Office is asking you to keep your eyes out for this man. Deputies say 41-year-old Michael Taylor is wanted in connection to an aggravated stalking case from March 18th. He is known to be around the Hillcrest Memorial Park off of Deansbridge Road in the Harrisburg area. If you have any information on this case, call the Sheriff's Office. Today, Governor Henry McMaster officially calling state lawmakers back to work next week for a special session. It's the first time this has happened in more than two decades. There are a number of bills left on the table, including more restrictions on abortion and bond reform. When lawmakers return to Columbia on Tuesday, it will be for the House to take up a bill banning abortions at around 6 weeks, with some exceptions.
I think it's high time to go on and make a decision that is acceptable to the vast majority, to the most of the people in the state. And there's no reason why they can't do that during this session. There's plenty of time for that.
The governor's executive order lasts through the end of the month. House Speaker Merle Smith said yesterday that lawmakers should be prepared to be there as long as it takes to come to an agreement. Some lawmakers calling the situation having the Augusta Green Jackets spending time today with patients at the Children's Hospital of Georgia. For the first time since 2019, the team brought a great energy and mood to the faces at the hospital. The team says community engagement is important to them, and since Augusta University is a founding partner of the team, it all clicks into place, and the kids are dealing with unimaginable hardship, and they deserve a smile on their face.
It was obviously an awesome opportunity for us, just to, you know, one, to be able to give back to the community a little bit, and two, just to see the smiles on these kids' faces that some of the guys brought. Obviously, we don't know everything, but we know that these kids are here for a reason and are going through a hard time, and you know, just hope that we can bring a little light in a Friday.
And the Green Jackets will also be auctioning off special jerseys in June, with the proceeds going towards the hospital. The U.S. Thunderbirds, the F-16 Viper team, and the Red Bull helicopter, and so much more will be on display. This is all happening at the Augusta Regional Airport this Saturday and Sunday. If you're interested in going, don't wait to buy tickets, because you cannot buy them at the event. Your last chance to buy tickets tonight. You can go to our website, WRDW, to learn more about that and grab those tickets. Coming up all new on News 12 at 6 o'clock, our Mikkel Hannah Harding will introduce us to a local teacher who's going for the flight of her life. Well, big news for some homeowners in Georgia, how a new law will help prevent being priced out of your home, Riley.
And we are tracking some pretty steady light rain across the Augusta Metro and heavier rain in a few spots in the CSRA. Update on the forecast just after the break.
Fresh for everyone.
We'll take a look at this. Severe storms moving through Oklahoma yesterday evening, bringing rain, hail, and tornado clouds in some areas. Definitely not something that you want to see. You want to be very far away from this, Riley. And I know that we have some weather moving through our area. Is there a potential for anything like this to happen?
Luckily not, Will. We're not expecting anything like, unfortunately, what they had to deal with last night. Pretty scary to see that imagery there. Next week, we have another high opportunity to see those storms Monday. Less of a chance Tuesday, but it looks like most of next week we'll at least have the chance for a few storms each afternoon.
Thanks, Riley. Sometimes the rise in property taxes price longtime homeowners out of the places that they've lived in for years or even decades. Joshua Skinner explains a new piece of signed legislation that is helping homeowners stay in those homes.
As property values increase, so too do taxes. And that can be bad news for longtime residents, including senior citizens.
They're on a limited income. Let's face it, you know, their money ain't gonna increase.
John Mason isn't from Decatur, but as a senior citizen, he's seen the problem grow in multiple areas. And it's problems like these that have the state of Georgia making sure residents don't get priced out of their homes, especially in areas like Decatur, where property values are skyrocketing. Governor Kemp signed bills earlier this month approving homestead exemptions for seniors. These exemptions lessen the taxable value of your home if you meet certain age and income requirements. Mason thinks actions like these are necessary.
Yes, I do. For long-term residents, permanent residents, and I think it's very helpful for seniors.
Which is why most of the exemptions apply specifically to people 62 years of age or older. Some also apply to people making under a certain income or with disabilities, helping keep Decatur home for those who've given it their time and money for decades.
They shouldn't be forced out because they can't afford to live there any longer. Accommodations should be made for the people.
And that law will last for the next 5 years and then will be reconsidered for renewal. Well, if you have a Windows PC, it's critical to update your computer right away. We're looking at a Windows update that keeps hackers from taking over your computer coming up next.
First Alert Clothing.
The most popular computer in the world is a Windows PC. You may have one in your home now.
To only the finest in men's clothing.
The most popular computer in the world is a Windows PC. You may have one in your home now. Microsoft is warning PC users to download a critical update as soon as possible. It was released just this week and prevents hackers from taking over your computer. Our consumer tech reporter Jamie Tucker explains why this is an update that you should do right away.
What the Tech, sponsored by WOW Internet.
Some people don't like installing updates, and for good reason. It can change the way you do basic tasks. It can also make things more difficult than what you're used to. But this Windows update is critical because it makes it more difficult for the bad guys to access your computer remotely.
Microsoft released this update May 9th, first discovered by the website Bleeping Computer. The Windows update includes 38 patches. Three of those are what's called zero-day vulnerabilities.
If you're unfamiliar with that term, 0 days means these are vulnerabilities that hackers already know and are already using.
These 0 days can be used to run tasks and actions over computers. They could actually bypass antivirus programs and install malware, and even worse, without this latest update, any PC can be hacked. Now, to install the updates, click on the Windows icon, make your way to Settings, then Windows Update, where you will see any updates that you haven't installed. Click Install All and wait. Depending on your internet speed, this can take 30 minutes or more. It's best to do it from home. You can still use your computer while it downloads. And once it's finished, you'll need to reboot the computer to install the updates.
The best way to protect your computer is to install updates as soon as they're available. This update is for Windows 10 and Windows 11 users. That's What the Tech. I'm Jamie Tucker.
Jamie says that you can also turn on automatic updates to install them as they're released.
Augusta University is having a lot of success on the golf course right now. The AU women's golf team has punched their ticket to the NCAA National Championship Tournament. And in less than 24 hours, their men's golf team is traveling to Auburn to compete in their NCAA Regional. With their talented underclassmen leading the way, this conference championship winning season has been filled with accolades for the Jaguars. In his first semester here in Augusta, South Africa native Stephon Jacobs won Southland Conference Freshman of the Year. Even though Jacobs is far from home, spending time on the golf course with his teammates and coaches is helping him settle in.
I used to play some team sports back in high school, and it's kind of been really cool to play again in a team environment. It was our goal to reach the regionals this year from the start of the season, so it's been really cool seeing all the guys work hard and finally getting it out there.
The NCAA Regional in Auburn begins on Monday and goes through Wednesday. Of the 13 teams in attendance, only the top five will advance. My full story with Stephon Jacobs and the AU men's golf team is coming up on News 12 at 6 o'clock.
All right, thank you for that, Dan. Looking forward to seeing that. And we are tracking some pretty heavy rain. We have a new flood advisory in effect for southern Jenkins County. This is along Highway 25 just south of Millen, staying in effect until 7:15. And potentially already 2 inches of rain has fell in that portion of the county. Better look at radar and the forecast just after the break. And this butterfly has an infamous namesake. What it's named after, that's coming up next.
The biggest
$500 total cash allowance when you trade in an eligible vehicle. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Wherever I go, I'm always keeping an eye on the power lines. In my home of Puerto Rico, Hurricane Maria showed us what can happen with a weak and outdated power grid. So I became an electrical engineer, and now I work for Georgia Power. We're investing in the latest secure technologies, and we're building the future of energy today. Our customers are counting on us for a modern and dependable power grid. And I'll be keeping an eye out to make sure they get it.
Save Adoption Center.
Well, this next story is for the Lord of the
Rings. Weekend at the Columbia County Exhibition Center.
Well, this next story is for the Lord of the Rings fans. A new group of butterflies are named after a Lord of the Rings villain. Researchers decided that the wing patterns of the butterfly led to name it Sorana. I think I said that right. It's inspired by the Eye of Sauron. That's a symbol of the main antagonist, Sauron, the Dark Lord in the series. This species lives in the Amazon rainforest. I think me and Dan just got into a shouting match because I argue with everyone, if you guys haven't figured that out already. He's a huge Lord of the Rings fan. I had to get a pronunciation from him, and I still don't know if I said it right or not, but that's pretty cool.
It's
cool looking butterfly.
Yeah, it's a pretty cool looking butterfly, and yes, Dan the Man Booth is definitely a big Lord of the Rings fan, we just learned.
I've never seen Lord of the Rings, so
I'm right there with you, Will, but I've heard it is pretty good. Definitely probably worth checking out. Maybe we get the reference for that butterfly if we do watch it. Hey, we're looking at I-20. This is looking towards the state line, so towards the Savannah River. You can see pretty congested here for this eastbound lane. Weather is definitely playing a factor with traffic today. We got some pretty wet conditions. Rain on the lens here, falling wet roadways. Temperatures have cooled off since the rain has started. Right now we're at 71 degrees here in Augusta. And right there at the state line, we just are seeing some returns for some light to moderate rainfall. The heavier rain has stayed mainly in Columbia County up towards the lake. And we actually do have a new flood advisory in the southern CSRA. And it looks like those storms up towards the lake, last couple of scans showing a weakening and not really seeing much lightning with these, but we are still seeing some lightning with this cell over Jenkins County right along Highway 25. That is where there is a new flood advisory in effect, and that is for rain totals already over 2 inches in that stretch of Highway 25. Here's a look at our weekend outlook for Mother's Day. We do have another decent shot to see those storms in the afternoon, so try to get those outdoor plans in early.
All right, thanks, Riley. That's all the time we have, but stick with us. Much more news, weather, and sports coming up after a short break on News 12 at 6 o'clock.